break your little bubble, but you gotta wake up to reality. Cause I can see in your eyes, your head is full of dreams. Tears are a proof of failure, you just gotta let them flow without judge.
Hello loves, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here today, my name is Siobhan. And y'all, guess what today it is? Today is finally Friday and it is Halloween weekend. So I am very excited about that. I'm getting ready to go and run a few errands. I need to go to the Halloween costume store to see if I can find, what am I looking for? Oh, I need a whip for my costume, and also I'm gonna just probably look around a little bit to see what else I can find. But I am so excited, y'all. I'm also so excited that today is Friday. It was a long week, a very long week. So I am looking forward to Halloween weekend, to all of the events and festivities I will be attending. Hold on, y'all. Let me see y'all. Yeah, I'm about to get ready to run a few errands and just to see if missing anything that goes with my costume, just to look around to see what they have, if I want to change anything up, which I'm sure I probably won't. I have two costumes I have three costumes. One of them I made, the other one I didn't make it, but I kind of put it to, well, actually the other two I didn't make them like by hand. I didn't sew them, but I did put them together. It wasn't something that was like packaged. I don't really care for the pre-packaged costume because I feel like everybody always have the same stuff on, and like I said, I really like Halloween, so I try to be different and do my own little thing. But yeah, I'm about to get ready to head out and go run a few errands. So yes, I'm really, really excited about this weekend. This week, our past month, a few months, I haven't been feeling the best. Not like a sick thing or anything, just like mentally I just haven't been feeling the best and feeling things. So I am looking forward to this weekend to try to get out of this rough patch I've been dealing with. But yeah, y'all, so I'm about to get ready to head out. What I need to do is try to get a new purse, everyday purse, because I really hate this purse that I wear, but it's convenient, so I just keep it, and it's my purse, my everyday purse that I just pretty much wear to the gym. Is it cold outside? I believe it is. Yeah, so I'm about to get ready to head out. I probably make another stop on my way to the costume store. I'm kind of hungry, so I might stop and get myself something to eat. I'm not sure yet. I'm super, super chill today. Nothing too much. Just like a real comfortable outfit, kind of like a gym outfit. I have on this, like a little, I guess, fitness set, and I just threw on a little jean jacket because it is cold outside, or it'll probably be cold outside by the time I come back. I have on the, are these don'ts? No, I guess they are. I think they're ones. I have on some ones, and yeah, just real cool, chill, nothing too much. So I'm gonna go ahead on and head out. And this is the ugly purse I was telling y'all about, just like a little denim bag, but it's big enough to hold all my stuff, so I guess that's why I keep it on. But yeah, these are the vibes, real chill, and I will see y'all in a few. Alright y'all, we just making it to the costume store, Spirit Halloween, Spirit Costumes or whatever it's called. So I'm gonna go in here and see what they have that I might need or not need, but of course still get. Cold that it out here as I thought it was, but it's okay. Last day of business, November 2nd. I didn't know they stay open after Halloween. Alright, let's see what we have. And I should not have came here, because I hate when I have my stuff already and then I'll come back and find something that I like that I really don't need and end up spending unnecessary money. I'm surprised everything is fully stocked because it's so close to Halloween. Usually everything is all picked over, but it's not. I'm looking at some fishnets that I could use. I already have some fishnets, but I really like have the ones with the moon and the stars on them that I could probably use, but you don't need to spend no unnecessary money on no fishnets right now. But I can use the ones I have. I did see this scarecrow kind of, not costume, but I guess the pieces that you could put together for the scarecrow that I like. Excuse me, ma'am. Can you tell me what the scarecrow costumes are? The scarecrow costumes?
They're probably going to be a fat boy. Did you check on the specs though?
Yes. She was no help at all. But it just kept looking like I was doing. So I seen this scarecrow. Well, actually, I didn't see it. I was on the phone with my sister, and she was showing me this the stuff that you can use to make a scarecrow costume, and it was really cute. So I'm gonna try to find that and get myself up out of here. Let me try to get some help to find this, and I will be right back. All right, so I finally found the scarecrow accessories, and they have two different types of hats, but I'm so scared that the hats are too small. And these are the hats. Accessories. But I can I can guarantee that these hats will be too small for my head. But we gonna try and see. They also have this cute little choker. Cute, real cute. I will probably just wear the hat and choker and maybe like do some face painting on my face and wear like a brown bodysuit. But I have to make sure that this hat is gonna fit on his head. You gonna see. I have like a skirt, little skirt thing that's real cute. Try to set y'all up. This is good, you are right, but I had this ponytail. I am sure that's going to be good. They also have this little mini hat, which is kind of cute. Just sit on top of your head, I guess. All right, y'all, so I'm gonna get myself up out of here. I guess I don't need nothing, which is a good thing. Because your girl is trying to save money. Alright, so that was that. I guess I could have just not came here because I really, like I said, I didn't need nothing, but you know how it is. Just coming to make sure because I would hate to start getting dressed and last minute I realize I need something. But it's fine because I save money. It's kind of hot out here and I got this damn jacket on. All right, y'all, so headed to the next spot. I will see y'all in a few. All right, y'all, so we are about to go. Since I'm in the area, I'ma stop at Five Below to get some, I need some, like some little storage boxes or like a storage shelf type deal thing to organize my little area where I like record everything and do work on the computer, do my makeup and all of that type stuff. So it's in my bedroom, but the bedroom is pretty big. I mean, it's a nice size, so it don't clutter up the room, but I want a little more organization. So I'm gonna try to go find some hopefully I can find like a little shelf that I can mount to the wall, something small, not too big, just something so I can put everything in order. I hate clutter. I hate wires hanging everywhere. I hate all that type of stuff because it makes everything just look so out of order. And I try to keep everything in order, try to keep the room at least looking decent, other than when I'm getting dressed, y'all, because y'all know how that is. Ladies, y'all know how we do when we getting dressed and putting makeup on. By the time we get back, it's a whole hurricane. We got to clean up clothes everywhere, makeup left out. We got to clean brushes and all that type of stuff. So I don't need no extra stuff just hanging around. So that's the deal. So I'm gonna try to go get some storage boxes or whatever it is I can find. Five Below usually have some pretty nice stuff because I got some stuff from there not too long ago just to like decorate the little area to make it look a little better, because since I've been getting into content creating and since I started my YouTube channel, I've been trying to, I guess, make the area comfortable so that I want to be there, so that it feels good. And not that it's not comfortable, but I want to make it look, you know, nice. So that's what we're about to do. We're gonna head into Five Below. Hopefully I don't see nothing else I need to get, I want to get, because I ain't trying to spend no extra money right now. But, and I think I'm gonna head to Starbucks after, because I want to try one of their new fall season drinks, because I never had one. I'm not really into pumpkin and spice and all of that type of stuff, but I did see something that I might like. So I think I'm gonna take myself on a little Starbucks date and do a little taste test. So we are about to go to Five Below and see what they got. Let's see. See what I can find, y'all. Hello, how you doing? They usually have real nice stuff in here. I got some stuff from here not too long ago, like some little plants, some little fake plants. We're gonna see what they got. So these are the little plants I got the last time I came. These right here, those are real cute. They have all this little section, like the greenery section. You can use like little pitches and stuff. So yeah, they have some pretty nice stuff. Let's see what we can find. Y'all, so I just left Five Below. Actually, I'm still sitting outside of Five Below. I think I want to go to Starbucks, take myself on a little Starbucks date, because I have been wanting to try one of the fall flavor drinks, and I just have not. I don't know. I'm really not into the pumpkin spice and a lot of the fall flavors, but I did see one that I might be interested in, so I think I'm gonna go ahead on and order it on the app. I love Starbucks, but I just haven't been, I don't know. I really haven't been going lately. I used to go a lot when I was on bikini prep, but I couldn't really get certain drinks. I couldn't really get none of the good drinks because they had so much sugar and fat in them. So I would stick to like the more boring drinks, but I would just have it just because it was something. But yeah, I never really tried none of the really, really good drinks. So I think today we might try one of those out. and I might just go have me a drink and hang out a little bit. I feel like I don't get out enough, like I don't go on enough outings, dates and stuff like that. So I think I'm gonna start like going on solo dates. Sometimes you have to really just do things yourself. Like, I mean, of course you would probably prefer to be, you know, there with somebody, but sometimes you just have to, you know, do things on your own. You feel like you don't do certain things enough, you have to take it upon yourself and just do the things that you want to do and enjoy that time alone. Enjoy that time to yourself if you can. Like, maybe, I don't know, whatever it is you want to do, scroll on Instagram, plan some stuff out if you want to do work or whatever it is you want to do. But it's the weekend, child. We ain't trying to do no work on the weekend. So let me see, I'm gonna put my order. So it's called the iced apple crisp oat milk macchiato, but we ain't doing no oat milk. So I think I'm gonna substitute the oat milk for almond milk. And yeah, I think I'm gonna try that. That sounds pretty good. All right, so let me go ahead on and put this app order in. And it should be ready by the time, oh girl, I need some gas. Your girl is on E. I'm always on E. I don't know. Siobhan, you gotta get it together. I'm always on E. I feel like I don't know what I do with gas. I feel like I fill my tank up in the next 2 days, I'm on E again. Ain't no way I do that much driving. Ain't no way I'm doing that much driving. I don't know what's going on. All right, so we're gonna substitute the oat milk for almond milk. Light ice, very, very light ice. I don't like a whole lot of ice in my drink because I feel like once it melt, you got a whole cup of water and we ain't trying to pay for no cup of water. All right, so let's see. We gonna do that and update item. And we gonna wait on and pay for that. And we gonna place that order. All right, y'all, so we just made it to Starbucks and Starbucks is crowded as hell, but I am excited to taste this drink. I'm a little hungry too, probably should have got something to eat. I think what I'm gonna do is, I have a little time, so I'm gonna sit outside and enjoy my drink with y'all and just talk a little bit and enjoy the vibes. Okay. Alright, let me set y'all up. We gonna see what this drink hitting for. Y'all see me? Alright, so like I said, this is the apple oat milk macchiato, but I substituted the oat milk for almond milk. And we gonna see what it tastes like. Delicious, so good. Probably would have been even better with the oat milk because I've never had oat milk actually, but I hear oat milk is really thick and creamy, so it tastes really good with these coffee based drinks. But I ain't trying to get the oat milk, so this is good though. This is really good. It's almost like a apple cinnamon flavor. It's really good. But yeah, y'all, I feel like I just need to start getting out more and, you know, grabbing a cup of coffee or grabbing a bite to eat or just going to, like, maybe, I don't know, coffee shop, just hanging out, chilling. Even if I'm going and listening to a podcast or doing stuff on my phone, getting work done, whatever it is, I just feel like I need to start doing that more. And I feel like we as adults, like we need it sometimes. Like we need that time away and just like time out to do you know, some of the things we like to do, even if it's just catching a little break. Because life can get rough. It really can. Like being a parent, working, you know, work week is pretty stressful. And just life itself just can be stressful. And I feel like that's where I'm at with it. I feel like I'm Monday through Friday, I'm really just like running around, seeing clients, trying to do now, create content in between, trying to figure things out and trying to still keep like some kind of balance of social life and fun. And I feel like that's like one of the hardest things to do. And I mean, just being a parent can be like really, really rough at times. As much of a blessing it is, it can get stressful. It really can. Especially depending on, you know, the amount of kids you have and what age group they're in. That can get really stressful. And sometimes we as parents, like, we lose ourselves. Like, we forget about what about the things that you like to do, what about the things you did before. You know, before you were a parent, like, we still have to do those type of things. And I feel like when those things start to lack, that's when we start to feel really, really stressed out and just like overwhelmed. And I feel like that's where I'm at with it. I feel like I'm just so into, like, it's just like adulting, you know, being a parent, paying bills, working, trying to keep up with everything, trying to keep up with dentist appointments, doctor's appointments, hair appointments, making sure schoolwork is done, making sure, you know, Nyla is on top of her schoolwork and everything is done, making sure stuff around the house is done. It's just like, hold up, you know. And I feel like I need to start throwing more of the fun things in. And that's just like, I'm like, on the weekends, y'all know how I feel. If y'all know me, y'all know how I feel about my weekends. Like, I'm not trying to do nobody work on the weekends, because when is my time gonna come? You know what I'm saying? If we working Monday to Friday and then we working again on the weekends, back to Monday again, you are bound to be stressed out. That is a disaster for stress. And just being overwhelmed. This is really good, but I think this straw broke, because it ain't nothing really coming out here, and it's coming out the sides. But we gonna work with it. But yeah, I feel like we need to start, like, as adults, we deserve to do more of the things that we want to do. Yeah, when we have kids, you know, they always say put your kids first, but you have to, you cannot pour from an empty cup. So if you don't have, you know, you together, you cannot be there to fully be mentally there for your kids or anybody else for that matter. So I feel like, you know, we have to do these things and try to be in a good mental space. Not just for our kids, but for ourselves. Well, after you have kids, you don't lose yourself. Like, you're not just a parent. There is a person, you know, in that body that has likes and desires and needs and wants. And sometimes you have to fill those, because you cannot pour from an empty cup. I'm back. I am just making it back inside. Actually, I've been inside about 20 minutes, so I had to cut my little Starbucks chat date thing short, because of course my battery died. I came home and I dropped my daughter off to her grandmother's house. It is 5:38 p.m. right now. So I dropped her off, came home, let my camera charge a bit. And so I did get some stuff from Five Below. I got four shelves, because they come two to a pack. I got two packs, so I got four little shelves that I need to put up. I might do that a little bit later. And I think that's about it. And also, I need to take up one of my costumes that I'm wearing this weekend. I'm not sure if I'm wearing it Saturday or Sunday, but I need to get that taken up, because it is too big, y'all. And we need to get that, you know, fitted and stuff. So I'm gonna do that. And then after that, I'll probably start organizing my little area, putting my shelves up. So I will let y'all see me do that. And then, I mean, I'll talk to y'all later once I start. Hey, y'all. I'm back. So I'm about to show y'all what I got from Big Lots. Five Below. The little shelves I got that I was telling y'all about. These are them. These are the shelves. They are a little bit smaller than I wanted, than I kind of needed, but you gonna make it work, child. So I have four of these, and I think I'm gonna just mount them like right over each other, or maybe straight line is fine. All right, so you need a screwdriver, you need a drill, a pencil, and that's it. So let me get to work. Taking my all into one up that I'm wearing for my costume today, and right now I'm just pinning it so that I can take it up to my size. This is, I believe this is a large, and I wear like a small, extra small sometimes, so I got a lot to take it up to do. So this is, let me get y'all so y'all can see how I'm doing this. Put y'all a little lower. So this is what I did so far, and this is what I have to do. Get it to my size, so I'm taking up equal amounts on each side, which is a lot, but we gonna get it together. So let's see. These are pins. I'm using the big ones. I'm just pinning it where I need it to be. About right here. So the problem is I'm tall, so with bodysuits, sometimes I have to get like a bigger size or just whatever they have so it can be long enough. But then the problem is it's too big. So we're gonna do that there, take that up, and I will be back once I am done. So y'all, today I am very excited. Like I told y'all, so today I will be going to my first Halloween party, festivity, event. So I'm very excited about that. Today I have a few things to do. So the last time I talked to y'all was when I was telling y'all I had to take my costume up, and I was putting those shelves up. Those shelves stressed me out. Like I said, they are a little bit smaller than I would have preferred, but they'll work. So yeah, last night I went ahead and I took that costume up. It fits perfect. Fits your girl like a second skin. That took like all of 5 minutes. And after that, I just chilled out. I listened to some podcasts. I watched some YouTube a little bit. I had a drink, y'all. I needed me a drink last night. Last night just wasn't it for me. But yeah, I had me a little drink. I watched a podcast, listened to YouTube a little bit. I edited some thumbnails that I needed. Actually, the thumbnail that I needed for my the DIY costume video I should post. It should be posted today. But oh, let me show y'all these shelves that I put up, y'all. I struggled, okay? Your girl struggled to do these damn shelves. So this is the outcome. I put my little camera equipment on here. I gotta straighten it out a little bit because it's a little sloppy right now. But we're gonna get to it. My main focus was just putting the putting everything on the shelves. So I'll fix that in a little bit. But today, I don't have much going on today. I wanna go back to the costume store. Y'all know I went to the costume store yesterday, and for some reason, I just wanna get something else just in case, because I feel like I may wanna do the scarecrow costume, and I may wanna just have it just in case. And if I get it and I don't wear it, I can always wear it next year. It'll all stay the same. So today I don't have a whole lot to do. I did my hair yesterday for my costume that I'm wearing today. So that's done. I really need to be at somebody's nail shop. These toes, y'all, it don't even make no sense. But I'm definitely not going to the nail shop today on a Saturday. And because it's Halloween weekend, nail shop be extremely crowded. I try not to go in the nail shop on the weekends because I don't like being in there with all those people. Today I need to make a t-shirt for Johnny's costume that he should be wearing tonight. I might go see my little nephew today, and probably just chill out a little bit, hang out, and that will be about it. So I will talk to y'all when I start working on my next move, which probably will be making this t-shirt. Might give me something to eat too. But anyway, I hope y'all are having an amazing morning. What time it is? Oh, it's 10:06, so I have some time. So I'm gonna just hang out. I might get me a little breakfast, and I will see y'all later. Hey, loves. So I'm finally back. It is, let's see, 3:25, and I went to see my nephew. Ran some errands with my sister, went to do some little last minute shopping. I'm moving to the beauty supply store, picked up a few things, so I'm just getting back. And as I told y'all in my last video, I am in the everything room. So this is where I sew at. This is where we keep all of our lawn equipment, everything, storage, everything, pool equipment, everything. So anywho, I just got back and I printed out the wording that I'm putting on Johnny's shirt. I didn't record that because I was just trying to get it done. But now I'm in here in the back. I just heated up the heat press machine, which is right here. So I'm about to heat press his shirt and get that out of the way. And then I'm gonna just chill out a little bit. Might have me a glass of wine. Start looking at makeup to see how I'm gonna do my makeup for tonight. And just chilling out. So I'm gonna let y'all watch me do this little heat press real quick. So this is just a single heat press machine. And what I do is, so his shirt, it's a black shirt. So to get everything pretty even, what I do is I put the seams together, put the shoulder seams together to get this little center right here, so I can know exactly where the center is to put the words. So what I'm gonna do is actually, I'm gonna do it this way. Let's switch it around so I can get this center mark right here. So I'm gonna press it, and I use this little, where is it? Okay, so I use this. This is just some parchment paper just to protect the shirt from the, in direct contact with the heat from the heat press. So it'll be on a parchment paper and not directly on the shirt. And then let's close that down. Just for about, this is set for 30 seconds, but I just do like 10 or 12 for them just so I can get that midline. And then what I do is I open the shirt up. So now I know exactly, you see that? Where the center is of the shirt, which is right here. And then I lay it on the machine. And so this is the print that I made for the shirt. So what I do with this is I just fold this in half so I can know exactly what a halfway mark is, so I can even the halfway mark up with the little halfway mark I made on the shirt. So the little midline, center seam, or whatever you want to call it, you know what I'm talking about. All right, so I like to start my words on a t-shirt like 4 fingers down from the neckline of the shirt. So I put my 4 fingers here, and then I'll try to start like somewhere right here with a word. So it's about here. And then I just try to make sure it's kind of straight. So I flatten that out a little bit. Put y'all up so y'all can see a little bit better. All right, we'll press that on a little bit. And then I just like to hold a shirt up to take a visual look at it from afar to see if it's even. And it's pretty even, but I feel like one side can go up, I feel like this side can go up a little bit. So I'm gonna just raise that up a little bit. Put it there. Pat that down. And this is even. So I'm gonna just lay this back on a heat press machine. Get my parchment paper. And I'm gonna close this down for 30 seconds. So once the machine beeps, then it lets me know that it's done. But sometimes I like to put it back on for a little longer, just depending on how the letters are after I let it cool down a bit. And I like to let it cool down a little bit so it won't be as sticky, but not too long, because sometimes it makes the paper starts to, the actual plastic starts to stick to the shirt. All right, so that's that. Put that to the side. And then I'm gonna just let this cool off a little bit right here. Not too much, just to make sure everything is already on. And as you can see right here, the it's starting to, so you can see that's already sticking, which is good. That's a good sign. So I'm gonna just start peeling it off just like this. And sometimes you got to be careful, because if the letters aren't stuck all the way to the shirt, then you can mess the shirt up and pull some of the letters off. But this came out pretty good, so I'm gonna just press it one more time, and I'm gonna put this directly on top of here. Yeah, like I said, it is very messy back here, so don't judge me, okay? It's very messy back here. There's a lot going on back here. And sometimes I just let this go for about an extra 15 minutes. So I'll do 15 minutes here. Take it up. And this is what we have. And that is Johnny's Tatsu's costume. He wanted to make. All right, so that was it, real quick and simple. So now, like I said, I think I'm gonna go inside. I'm gonna have him try everything on, make sure everything, come on lighting, make sure everything is fitting good. Y'all don't judge my do-rag. You know, of course I had to tie the edges up, but yeah, I think I'm gonna just go inside and start to look at, like I said, what types of makeup I want to do for tonight. I'm thinking about some kind of like dark smoky eye. I'm not sure yet. And I'm finally about to do my makeup. I haven't really decided on what look I want to go for, but I know it's going to be something dark. Like a, maybe a black and silver, maybe a black and silver smoky eye. I'm going to just set y'all up real quick. Yeah, so it is almost that time. Start getting ready, getting everything together. I still haven't put everything together yet. So, honestly, I don't even know how this costume looks, but I think we're gonna be fine. So anyway, like I said, I think I'm gonna do the black and silver smoky eye because my costume is all black and the accessories have like little silver grommets on them, I guess. So I think we're gonna go with black and silver instead of black and gold. Y'all, I can't never talk and do my eyebrows at the same time, so let me do these brows and I will be right. Okay, so the brows are done and now we are good to go. So I'm gonna start applying this foundation. This is some cheap foundation. It's L'Oreal Paris, but I've been using this for a while and I really like it. It is Nut Brown C7. Like $7-$8 at Walmart. But it's really good. I like it. Y'all, it's something about getting those brows done and getting your makeup done and getting dressed that makes you feel like a whole different person. Or at least I do. Because during the week, I be like, in a crappy mood, like not really feeling it. Just like looking bummy Monday through Friday pretty much because I'm back and forth in and out the gym with clients, so I really don't get too dressed up. I just really throw on the first thing that I see and get my day started. But y'all, see when I put them lashes on, get them brows done? Girl, you can't tell me nothing. Nothing. And I said I was gonna start getting dressed up more just to make feel better because I feel like, well, for me, when I get dressed up, I feel better, like my mood is different. Puts me in a better mood, so I think I need to start getting dressed up a little bit more. I just have to find time and the best times to do it because, like I said, I'm in and out the gym all day with clients, so usually like Friday and Saturday are like my only days I can really do that, and Sunday sometimes, but Sunday is usually like a house chore day, kind of like relax day, get the house in order, clean up a little bit. Get the kid, I got foundation all on my lip. Get the kid ready for school. You know, all that type of stuff, getting ready for the work week. But I feel like as women, that makes us feel good. And it also helps us, like I feel like women have this bad, like comparing themselves to other women and people they see on Instagram. Whether it's like the body, physical appearance, or just like material things that they have and our goals, careers, and things like that. But you have to really, and we do it, and sometimes we do it not knowing we're doing it, but you have to just enjoy what you have and know that your journey is your journey and what's for you is for you and nobody can take it away. And another thing is that timing is everything. We want stuff when we want it, but everything happens on God's timing. And you just have to wait your turn. And everything ain't for you. Like, everything ain't for everybody. Everybody won't have the same success. Everybody won't have the same, you know, successes when it comes to careers. My sister. Hello? I didn't get no call. I don't know what's going on with my phone. I didn't even get that last FaceTime. That was my sister calling. But like I was saying, we compare ourselves to other people and their journey, and it just eats away at our own joy and kind of like make us downplay our successes and things we've accomplished, our accomplishments, because we're looking at other people, not even knowing their story, not even knowing if, you know, what they're posting is actually what's happening, because
social media is just you posting what you want to post or what you want people to know. So you post those highlights of, you know, the good things that happen in your life. Some people may post the bad too, but for the most part, we see the good and we start to compare it to ourselves. So it's kind of like, if we're not at least where these people are or ahead, then it starts to make us feel like we're failing. And it starts to make us rethink some things and just kind of like not think the best of ourselves. But I mean, social media can be a good thing, but it also can be a downfall, a distraction. And sometimes once you realize you feel a certain type of way after being on social media, it's time to get off, or it's time to unfollow those certain people, because you have to do what's best for you and what makes you feel your best. And like I said, you have to know that everything ain't for you. It's just not. Like, everybody, unfortunately, everybody won't be rich. Everybody won't have fame. Everybody just is just not for everybody. And you just have to realize that and enjoy your own journey. And I find that, I know men do it too. I'm just not a man, so I don't really know to what extent. I'm a woman, so I know women do it. And I get, you know, a lot of people, a lot of women saying, oh, I want to look like this. Oh, I want my body to look like this. I want to have these things. I want this type of car. I want that, you know. And it's just like, that's not for everybody. And it's okay to have those goals and dreams and to work towards those things. But in the meantime, you just have to enjoy what you have and where you are and just enjoy life at that point, while you're working towards more or that bigger goal. And it's kind of like, I'm seeing these videos about women talking about leveling up and how to level up. And it's like, a lot of those videos are like, a lot of those videos are talking about leveling up in a way of like a monetary way, with, you know, having a certain type of money, a certain lifestyle, being able to afford, you know, certain type of things. And all those things are fine, but it's a lot more that come with leveling up, like maturing, wisdom, growth, a lot of things. So those are not the only ways to level up. So it's kind of like, when you watch those videos, you have to take everything with a grain of salt. So this is the finished look. I just got done. So I'm about to take my shower, put my clothes on, you know, do my last minute little preparations before I head out. And I will see y'all in a few. I'm back, y'all. We are ready to roll. And these are the vibes. Dominatrix Bunny. We are ready to go. Let's see. See y'all at the party. All right, y'all, we made it to the party. Let's go. You got the drink?
What drink?
Oh, I got it.
Lock the step.
Lock it up. I can't see with this damn mask on. Only got 9 minutes left on my thing. On the SIM card.
Right here.
Are they outside? I'm just a little bit.
Happy Sunday. Well, actually, is it still morning? Yeah, it's 11:28. So, y'all, I had the time of my life yesterday at the Halloween party. I was supposed to record a little bit more and get up this morning and record, but yesterday I ended up having so much fun that I just put my camera down after a while. And this morning I didn't do too much. I just really got myself up and out the bed, got myself together. So now I'm about to head out. We're going to another Halloween party tonight at a club called Metro. So we're about to head out. I need to go get some last minute stuff to finish up my costume. And also I'm kind of thinking about changing my costume. So I may or may not do that. We'll see. So I might go to the costume store, Walmart. Actually, I need to go to Walmart to get another SD card because I only have 4 minutes left on this card. So yeah, so I'm going to go head out to Walmart. To the costume store. I need to go to the beauty supply store again. I also need to fix my hair over because for the costume I'm wearing today, I'm wearing a wig. So I have to take this ponytail out because, of course, the wig cannot fit over the ponytail. And I didn't want to take my hair out because I just did it yesterday, which means after I take this wig off tonight or tomorrow, I'm going to have to do it again. But it's okay. So anyway, y'all. So yes, I will get back to y'all after I get my new SD card because I'm running out of storage. And I will see y'all in a few. So we are back in the Halloween store. I'm still undecided on what I want to do. I have the scarecrow costume. I might do that. I'm still undecided. Oh, I could use my camera as a mirror. So we can see how this looks. Looking at some Halloween stuff. I ended up picking up a Halloween bag for Nala, and I just was looking to see what else they had. I ended up not getting nothing from the costume store, so I'm gonna just go ahead on and wear the costume I already planned and call it a day. And I ain't too mad at that because I saved some money. So that is that. I did get Nala this little Halloween trick-or-treat bag right here. Just something simple for her to have for when she go trick-or-treating tomorrow. And I am starving. I think I'm gonna go ahead and grab me something to eat because I ain't eat nothing all day. And of course my camera is about to die, so I'll see y'all in a few. Hey loves, so I just pulled up at Home Depot. I'm about to try to get some spray paint, the spray paint that I was supposed to get at Walmart, but I didn't get it because I was so busy looking at stuff in Walmart that I did not go in Walmart for that. I forgot what I did go in there for. So I forgot the spray paint. I went to Walmart, I think the last time I talked to y'all, I was at Walmart, and I went home, I took me a little nap. So it's 6:06 p.m. now, and I just got to Home Depot. I'm about to try to see if I can find this green spray paint to spray paint this little piece on my wings tonight, for my costume that I'm wearing tonight, because it is pink and my costume is green, so it kind of like stand out once I put it on, so you can see like the little straps, and then it's this little centerpiece on top of the wings that is pink as well, and I would prefer it to be green so it can kind of like blend in, you know, with the costume. So I'm about to see if I can find that and run home and spray paint that and let that dry before it's time for me to leave. So that's what we're doing right now. We're about to go to Home Depot to see what I can. Alright y'all, so I just made it back home. I am currently in a backyard. I'm about to get ready to try to paint the wings. This is the spray paint that I found that kind of matched the color of my costume. So I'm gonna try to do that real quick and see how this turns out. I'm gonna set y'all up real quick. These are the wings here. They're kind of small, child. So this looks like a drip. What are those things called? Those little bugs, those type of wings. But we gonna work with them. It looked much bigger online, but they ain't big at all. All right, so this is what I wanna try to spray paint, and I just don't know how I'm gonna get the spray paint not to get on the other part of the wings. We gotta rig this up some kind of way. So I got this aluminum foil. Try to see if that works. I'm gonna just have to be real careful with spraying them. So that's how I'm gonna do that. And we're gonna see how that works. And here, I'm just kind of molded to fit under here, and hopefully it won't get on the wings. Hey y'all, so I'm back, and I just did my hair. As y'all can see, I got my hair in a little tie, a little bun. I got in a bun. I took a shower. I was supposed to wear a wig tonight, but it's 9:47. It's getting late. I need to start doing my makeup. I was supposed to wear a wig tonight, but the wig wasn't given what it was supposed to be given. It wasn't given Tinkerbell. I don't know what it was given. It was given raggedy Tinkerbell costume store, Walmart Tinkerbell. I don't know. It just wasn't given what I needed to give. So I went on ahead and put my own hair in a little bun. Did my edges, of course. So yeah, I'm about to get ready to do my makeup. Got me a little drink, like I said. Yeah, so I'm not gonna record me doing my makeup because I recorded it yesterday, and you know, it's kind of boring. So I might do a quick little montage of me doing my makeup and getting ready, and I will see y'all in a few. I'm excited. I'm ready to go and have myself a good time, and I will see y'all once I start getting ready, once I start doing something with a little action. Y'all, so this is the finished look, and these are the Tinkerbell vibes, and I'm gonna put this little white purse because I need somewhere to put my phone and my money. So this is it, Tinkerbell. I'll see my little bun, and we are out the door. See y'all in a few. happy Halloween. So today is Halloween and I am kind of excited about that. I'm not doing too much today. I'm bringing my daughter trick-or-treating, so that's exciting. We get to put our costumes on, dress up, so I am excited about that. Y'all see where my hair was tied up at? I had an amazing time last night. I had fun. It was really nice. We got inside real late last night. Well, this morning, actually. We didn't get inside till about 3:30-ish, maybe 4 o'clock. May have been 4 o'clock. But we had a really good time, so it was well worth it. I'm not tired of anything, surprisingly. I am a little hungry, so I think I'm going to go and fix me some. I don't really want no breakfast right now. I think I just want some noodles, like something really hot. Because like I said, I had a few drinks last night, so I feel like something hot would be perfect. I'm feeling good, energized. So like I said, I don't have a whole bunch to do today. I have a dentist appointment at 12 o'clock. So it's 10:06. So I think I'm gonna just fix me some noodles, eat me some noodles. And then I have a mess to clean up in the bedroom because y'all know how it is when we getting dressed. We doing makeup and, you know, all of that girly type stuff. So I have a mess to clean up, which it probably won't take me too long. So I'm gonna fix me something to eat and I guess I'm gonna fix me something to eat, clean the bedroom, and I have a dentist appointment at 12. So by that time, let me get my noodles up, y'all. So by that time, it'll be time for me to go to my dentist appointment. And after that, I have a client at 1 o'clock, actually. So hopefully I'm done at the dentist by 1. And I'll see my client. I'm not seeing a whole bunch of people today just because I'm not seeing my later people today just because I want to take Nala trick-or-treating. So I rescheduled those people to tomorrow. So I don't have a whole lot of people to see today. So, I think I'm gonna just clean up a little bit until it's time for me to go to the dentist and run a few errands. I need to go to the UPS store because I have a return I need to bring back to Amazon. So I think I'm gonna do that, and then that will be pretty much it. And then by then it should be time to get Nala. So I'll get Nala from school. I think I have to get, she wanted a wig to go with her costume. So I might go look, or we might go look for her wig once she get out of school. And that is about it until we bring her trick-or-treating. So yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead on and get this mess cleaned up and get my day started. Thank you. up and out the house. I just got done cleaning up the room and everything, getting everything back in order. And I just wanted to pop in before I go to my dentist appointment to talk about something. So last night we ran into some friends at the Halloween party, and after the party was over, we ended up just hanging around talking a little bit, and we were just talking about how you know, life is short. Life is really short, and as cliche as it sounds, I know you hear it all the time. It's always thrown around, but I feel like sometimes we take it lightly, and we don't take advantage of things. And it's kind of like sometimes we feel like we always have another chance. We always have tomorrow. Like, oh, there'll be tomorrow. I can do it tomorrow. I'll see it tomorrow. We won't always have tomorrow. Tomorrow won't always be there. One day tomorrow won't come. So I feel like some things, like whether it's telling somebody something, telling somebody how you feel about them, telling somebody you love them, doing something, going on a vacation, checking something off your bucket list, marrying somebody, whatever it may be, if you want to do something, the time is now. Do it now. There may not be a tomorrow. That time may pass you by. You may not get a second chance to do that thing. So I feel like we don't always think about the fact that tomorrow may never come. Life is really short, and it's very cliche. We hear it all the time. We see it on Instagram all the time, but life is really short, and we won't always be blessed enough to have a tomorrow. Some just today didn't come for some people that were here yesterday. Some people didn't wake up this morning. So I kind of feel like we need to start doing things now and stop putting them off, thinking that we'll always have a second chance. And even if it's not you not having a second chance, as tomorrow not coming, whatever that thing is, that may be the only chance you get to do or to say that thing, whatever that thing may be. So I feel like we have to take advantage of that. Like, stop waiting until tomorrow. Stop putting things off like this. Tell somebody how you feel about them. If you love them, tell them you love them. If you want to mend a broken relationship, try to mend that relationship today. Don't wait until tomorrow. Tomorrow may never come for that person or for you. And I don't know, like, I've been thinking about that a lot lately, because I see so many people dying, so many people saying that they wish they would have done this, they wish they would have done that, oh, I wanted to do it, I was gonna do it. Tomorrow may not come. You may not have a chance to do or to say that thing tomorrow. So do it now. Like, take advantage of it now. We only live once, we only have one life, and it is a very short life. So take advantage of those things now. And that's it on that little rant. So I'm heading to my dentist appointment, and I will see y'all when I get out. Just checking in, because I haven't talked to y'all since probably since I went to the dentist. So I didn't do a whole bunch after that. After I came from the dentist, I went to UPS store. I had to ship something off. I had to go run a few errands. I had to go to Office Depot, and now I'm inside. So I'm just sitting inside waiting for Nala to get home from school. And then I'll see if she have homework. If she have homework, we'll get homework done. And probably fix something to eat, and probably start getting ready for tonight to bring her trick-or-treating. So we might go trick-or-treating around 5:30-ish, 5:30, 6 o'clock. It is 3:55. So within the next hour and a half to 2 hours, we should be getting ready to go trick-or-treating. And when I come back, we should be dressed and have our costumes on and everything. So I will see y'all then. Hey y'all, so it is 6:27, and we are about to start getting ready to head out to bring the kiddo trick-or-treating. I think I want to put on a little makeup. Maybe I'll do my brows, and that will be that. I'm trying to figure out if I want to wear a jacket, because of it gets cold. I want to have something to put on my arms, because my costume don't have no sleeves. But then, if it's not cold enough, I don't want to be holding a jacket. So, I'm about to get ready, y'all. and we will head out in a few. Y'all, so this is the finished look for the Wilma Flintstone costume. If y'all watched the last video, y'all know that this was made out of 3 t-shirts, and this is the outcome. I really hate that my stocking showing at the top. My stocking showing at the top. I'm gonna have to wear this jacket. Y'all ready?
Mama, just put your stockings down.
They can't. I tried it. It's not working. Huh? That Wendy in the building.
Wendy said, bruh.
Sit. Sit down.
She excited.
I know.
Across the street.